Hi, welcome to my channel. In this video, our essay prompt is, some people say that vertical city is best, where people live and work in tall buildings. Others say that horizontal city is better, where there are few tall buildings. Discuss both sides and give your own opinion. So I have underlined some important words like vertical city and horizontal city. For vertical city, you can use different synonyms or topic related vocabulary words in your essay. So first is, you can use tall cities, tall buildings, tall cities, towering cities, architectural marvels. You can also use high altitude cities, crowded buildings, elevated cities, sky-high cities. So, sky-high, elevated, high altitude. These all cities means tall buildings or vertical cities. For horizontal city, you can write horizontal spread of cities, horizontal cities, low-rise buildings. Now look at the introduction. As the global population is rising, the cities are becoming more crowded. So population of the earth is increasing. So cities are being more crowded and people want to live in cities. They are moving from or migrating from the village to the cities. So cities are full of people. So the planners are in a dilemma as to which way to spread. Therefore, planners means architects who design the buildings. Planners, designers, or builders, you can say. So they are worried about how to manage the population in the cities. So the traditional spread is horizontal, in which cities grow outwards, whereas the vertical spread is upwards. Like you see in Dubai, there are so tall buildings there. And in other parts of the world also. Now the designers are focusing more on the tall buildings instead of the horizontal buildings, in which cities are growing upwards. Supporters of both have their arguments, which shall be discussed in this essay. I personally believe that horizontal cities are better for a good quality of life, but vertical cities would be the need of the coming times. So this is our first body paragraph. This is about advantages of vertical cities. So the concept of the vertical city is fascinating and attractive to some people for many reasons. In these type of cities, there are tall buildings, comma, which complex sentence, which accommodate a larger number of people. We all know that the population is burgeoning, and it is estimated that by 2050, more than 75% of the population will be in the cities. Land is scarce, and so the only option is to go upwards. So when we move upward, then these type of cities will be called sky-high cities, high-altitude cities. High-altitude means height, more height. And elevated cities, these all words have the same meaning, high altitude, elevated. So secondly, such cities also prevent the loss of the farmland and allow green spaces for parks, comma, which this is also a complex sentence, which are the lungs of the community. Moreover, water supply, central heating and cooling, waste disposal, etc. are more efficient when done in small spaces. Additionally, tall buildings are more attractive. So tall buildings, they are work of art, they are beautiful. Now third body paragraph, this is about the advantages of horizontal cities. So on the other hand, supporters of horizontal spread of cities cite a host of benefits. First, horizontal cities in which most buildings are low rise are better in case of natural calamities such as earthquakes. Secondly, high skilled architects and engineers are not needed for low rise buildings to make skyscrapers, which complex and dense, which can withstand the wind forces and can tolerate the brunt of earthquakes is not every builder's cup of tea. So horizontal cities are more economical as compared to vertical ones. Like अगर आप ये देखें दुबई, शारजा एंड अबू धाबी, वहाँ पे बहुत हाई बिल्डिंग्स हैं. मतलब उसको हम ये कह सकते हैं कि वो वर्टिकल सिटी है. तो अब वहाँ पे इतनी बारिश हुई है, इतनी ज़्यादा बारिश हुई है, और वहाँ पे कोई सिस्टम ठीक था ही नहीं. जो उनकी बिल्डिंग्स, अब जैसे उनके 20 अगर एक बिल्डिंग के फ्लोर्स हैं, तो वो 20th फ्लोर भी जो है उसकी जो रूफ थी उसमें सारा पानी आ रहा था फ्लोर पे, फिर 19th फ्लोर भी से वो जा रहा था 18th फ्लोर में, इस तरह से पानी उधर फ्लो कर रहा था. मतलब अगर 20th फ्लोर से वाटर मतलब रूफ से गिरना शुरू हुआ है तो वो नीचे तक जा रहा है, उनकी विंडोज से और हर जगह से, देयर वाज वाटर एवरीवेयर. इतना ज़्यादा उधर नुकसान हुआ है. तो इट मींस ये जो सारी गलतियां थी ये किसकी थी? ये गलतियां थी आर्किटेक्ट्स एंड इंजीनियर्स की, जो उन्होंने डिजाइन ही नहीं की बिल्डिंग्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द, कि अगर मतलब वहां पे बारिश नहीं होती है तो, अब वहां पे बारिश हो गई है, बहुत ज्यादा हो गई है, कितने सालों की बारिश एक दिन में हो गई है, लेकिन वो प्रिपेयर नहीं थे और वो प्रेपरेशन नहीं थी, लेकिन फिर भी उन्होंने क्लाउड सीडिंग करवाई, आर्टिफिशियल रेन उन्होंने करवाई. तो ये जो सारी गलतियां, ये जो उनके प्लानर्स हैं उनकी गलतियां हैं, जिन्होंने ये एक तो आर्टिफिशियल रेन करवाई और फिर उन्होंने ये नहीं देखा कि उनकी जो बिल्डिंग्स हैं वो इस काबिल नहीं है कि वो विदस्टैंड कर सकें. तो अब जो वाटर है वो तो हर जगह से अपना रास्ता बना लेता है, वो कहीं से भी जा सकता है, और अगर इस तरह से वॉल्स में से गुजरना शुरू हो तो दीवारों को खोखला कर देता है, और इस तरह से ये जो मिसहैप्स होते हैं वो इसी वजह से ही होते हैं. तो ये अब उनके लिए कितना नुकसान है ये सब. तो अगर यही लो राइज बिल्डिंग हो तो इतना उन्हें फेस ना करना पड़े, क्योंकि एक तो मसला ये है कि अगर वो पानी उसमें से गिरा था वो अब दीवारें कमजोर होंगी, इस तरह अगर एक दफा और फिर ये बारिश होगी तो ये गिरने का खतरा होता है. उनके प्लानर्स ने डिजाइन ही नहीं की इस तरह से बिल्डिंग, तो ये बहुत ज्यादा डेंजरस है. अब जो हवा भी इधर बहुत ज्यादा चल रही थी, स्काई स्क्रैपर्स ये हैं दुबई में, सो इस तरह से डिजाइन करने चाहिए विच कैन विदस्टैंड द विंड फोर्स एंड कैन टॉलरेट द ब्रंट ऑफ अर्थक्वेक्स इज नॉट एवरी बिल्डर्स कप ऑफ टी. क्या ये हर बिल्डर नहीं कर सकता? सो हॉरिजॉन्टल सिटीज आर मोर इकोनॉमिकल एज कम्पेयर टू वर्टिकल सिटीज. मोर ओवर पीपल हु लिव इन हॉरिजॉन्टल सिटीज कैन इंजॉय अ बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ. Horizontal cities can provide people with more natural light, views and ventilation. In horizontal cities, because of limited accommodation, the population is extremely small. Basically, low density of population ensures a high quality of life. Moreover, the competition is not so intensive than that in vertical cities. Therefore, people in horizontal cities have a better quality of life. A conclusion, to conclude, the present dream of people is a big house with a two-car garage. But as the population continues to grow and land becomes scarce, vertical cities may become an option worth considering. So, done. If you have any questions, you can ask me in comments. And if you like my videos, then subscribe my channel.